Good morning, everyone. I'm going to show with this video an example of the creation of service accounts with a custom role using Terraform, TerraGrunt, and CloudBuild for the CI/CD orchestration. This use case also allows to show an example of a less privileged principle. The less privileged principle is, for example, we have an identity. This identity can be a classical Google email or a Google group and also a service account email. An identity needs to access to some services in Google Cloud Platform. And these services can access to our resource via permissions and roles. In Google Cloud Platform, we have predefined roles that is proposed by GCP. But many times, a predefined role contains too much privileges, and it's not a best practice to give too much privilege to a resource. To an identity, many times the best practice is to give only the needed privileges to an identity or a resource that has the need to access to our Google services. Here you can see the schema of this use case. We have our code, our Terraform code is pushed in a GitHub repository in the main branch. We have then a CloudBuild trigger. For this use case, I choose to use manual CloudBuild triggers. CloudBuild is a serverless tool in Google Cloud that allows to perform some jobs that concern CI/CD part. Our CloudBuild jobs will launch the Terraform plan of our resources, the Terraform apply, and also at the end the Terraform destroy in order to clean all the resources used for this use case. The concerned resources are service accounts. We want to create a list of service accounts. And for each service account, we want to set some roles. We have, for example, predefined roles. We simulated predefined roles and also the assignation of custom roles to the expected service account. For this use case, we choose having two service accounts, one for Cloud Composer, for example, and the other for Dataflow jobs. The service accounts and the custom roles are managed in the Cloud IAM page in Google Cloud Platform. For the use case, the infra as code part that is pushed in the Terraform part is also managed with a wrapper called TerraGrunt. I wanted in this use case to propose a modular Terraform. We have, for example, two Terraform modules, one for service accounts and the other for the creation of custom roles. And when we create the service account, we assign the previously created custom roles. I wanted to show a separation of concern for my Terraform modules. And sometimes it's very good to separate the Terraform code in different modules. And when we play our Terraform modules natively with Terraform. It's little harder than when we do that with a wrapper like TerraGrunt. TerraGrunt uses the dry concept, don't repeat yourself. We can play many modules in one command. We have one command for the plan, one command for the apply. And also, TerraGrunt allows to configure a code in one place. And we can, for example, generate some Terraform files, some codes that it's needed for each module. And then this code can be imported in each Terraform module more easily without the repeating of code. It's interesting to show this use case because many times in some projects we can see some code logic that is repeated in many Terraform modules. I'm going to show the structure of the project in IntelliJ IDE. I have this project, SA Custom Roles GCP Terraform. I have a root folder that is infra. My root folder contains two Terraform modules, one for custom roles and the other for service accounts. the infra as code part is managed by TerraGrunt. For TerraGrunt, I have this first configuration file, TerraGrunt HCL file. This file centralizes some logic. For example, here I choose to use cloud storage as Terraform backend. With this code block and syntax, I can centralize the code logic of remote states. I have a backend TF file. I also get the cloud storage bucket given by substitutions with Cloud Build. I also get the TF state prefix, that is the folder that is pushed at the root of my bucket. I also can generate a version.tf file because in Terraform we use the native Google provider, the Google native provider, sorry, and this provider is needed for each Terraform module. That's why I generate the versions TF file. I get the Google provider version from a substitution variable provided by Cloud Build in order to upgrade more easily my code. With this configuration, it's interesting because the logic is centralized here at the root of the infra folder. Then, in each Terraform module, I have a child TerraGrunt HCL file. I can, with this syntax, I can import the parent HCL with the GCS backend and also the version.tf file. I have the same in the other module. You can see here that I have dependencies between custom roles and service accounts. Here, I want to show that these dependencies is very interesting because via this system, TerraGrunt will firstly will create the modules in the correct order and also will destroy the module in the correct order. Normally, the custom roles need to be created before the service accounts module. For the code, I can before to show the logic of the code, I can go to IAM page in Google Cloud Platform. In this page, we can handle and manage all the identities and all the security concern for our identity and service account. In this page, service account, we can create a service account, for example. And also, in this menu, roles, we can create custom roles. It's interesting because with the custom roles, I can set only the needed permission in my custom role. Then I can assign in the IAM page here, I can grant access and assign some roles or custom roles to an identity that can be a service account. After this, I go to my code. I have for my Terraform module, I configured my custom roles in a JSON file. I think the marriage between JSON and HCL code, Terraform code, can be very readable, configurable, and interesting. Here, the configuration is very human readable, and each person in a project or other outside of the project can easily manage a JSON list or JSON object. I have a parent node called custom roles. Here I want to create a custom role for Cloud Composer, for example. I have a role ID, a title, also a description. I have all the needed permission for Cloud Composer here. I simulated a less privileged principle here. I pushed only the needed permissions for Cloud Composer because Airflow, for example, in Cloud Composer will perform some actions for DAG and data pipelines. And for example, we don't want, for example, that Airflow can, for example, delete some BigQuery tables. It's not secure, and in order to prevent this kind of situation, we apply the less privileged principle. The other custom role is for Dataflow jobs. It's the same principle. I have the less privilege for Dataflow jobs. I have also only the needed permission for Dataflow jobs. As explained before, I don't want Dataflow jobs can, for example, delete BigQuery table or maybe delete a big table table. I propose only the needed permission for Dataflow too. And then this system is very interesting because in my Terraform code, I can propose some local variables. I have here a custom role that is a map. I load the custom role node here. This node corresponds to the parent node proposed in this JSON file. The locals can load the JSON file that is present in the current module via JSON decode. When I retrieve this JSON file, I can get a parent node, and in this case, I have a map, a Terraform map. I also have some variables, that is the current GCP project and also the current environment. In the main .tf file, what is interesting here with the marriage between JSON code and also Terraform code here is I don't have to repeat a resource per custom roles. I directly have a list of custom roles, a resource that handle and manage a list of custom roles. I have a for each with Terraform that loop on the previous showed custom roles proposed in locals here. I loop on my map, and for each element on my map, I will create a custom role. I have this resource that is provided by the native Google provider, Terraform provider, which have the responsibility to create a custom role. I propose all the parameters to create my custom roles, and at the end, I will create a custom role per element in my configuration, one for Composer and the other for Dataflow. After this, I have another module called Service Accounts. I have the same principle. I have a resource folder that contains a configuration file for Service Accounts. I have a parent node, Service Account, and also a Service Account for Cloud Composer and the other for Dataflow. I propose all the parameters for my Service Account, like the account ID, the display name, also the owner. And to have a human readable configuration, I propose a list of roles for my Service Account. I have the same principle for Dataflow and propose here I mixed voluntary two predefined roles proposed by GCP with the previously created custom roles for Cloud Composer. For Dataflow, I only set the custom roles created previously. In locals, I will load my Service Account map from the JSON file. I get the parent node for Service Accounts. And here, I need to flatten all my Service Accounts. And I need to flatten my list of Service Accounts per role. I will have, for example, SR1 role 1, SR1 role 2, SR1 role 3, SR2 role 1, SR2 role 2, and etc. etc. I flatten my Service Account list with all the roles. And then in the main TF file, I have a dedicated Terraform resource that allows me to create all the Service Accounts, which is based on the map created previously in locals. Then I have this Terraform resource project IAM member that allows me to, for example, set all my custom my roles and custom roles to my Service Account. I have my for each, and this for each is based on the essay rows flattened. This element I showed previously allows to calculate all my ESA with all roles flattened, and it's very interesting because I can with this kind of system I can easily have only one resource and do the assignation with only one Terraform resource. I have a kind of logic here to replace with a placeholder the project ID with the current GCP project ID passed as a Terraform variable. And I think it's good. I also have a depend on that indicates that this resource depends on the Google Service Account resource. And for the account IAM member, I only set this resource allows only to set the owner to the current Service Account. I think this code is very clear, and the marriage between JSON and HCL is interesting sometimes to remove some code lines with Terraform. and allows to have a human readable configuration. After this, all the Terraform code will be launched, will be created by from Cloud Build. Cloud Build is an orchestration tool which use a serverless approach. I choose to create three different Cloud Build files. I have a file for the plan, the other for the apply, and at the end, if I want to clean all the created resources for this use case, I can have, for example, a destroy YAML file. For the Terraform plan, I use TerraGrunt. With Cloud Build, I will perform and launch some commands. These commands will be launched from a Docker image. I use the official TerraGrunt Docker image in the name of my steps. I have the current working directory for this step, this Cloud Build step. Firstly, I perform an init with TerraGrunt because Terraform needs to download all the providers, all the needed providers which with the correct versions before to launch the plan. Then I have this command run all plan that will execute the planification in the correct order for all the Terraform modules with TerraGrunt. The dependency system is very important here because the custom roles will be performed before the service account in the correct order. I also have some environment variables and also with Cloud Build we can pass some external configurations that is called variable substitution. I pass some elements with variable substitutions like the TF state and GCS bucket that will host all the Terraform modules, also the root folder and prefix that will contain all the Terraform modules. The Google provider version is passed as substitution in order to upgrade more easily my provider Google provider version. And it's done for the plan. For the apply, I have the same logic here. All my Cloud Build jobs are manual jobs because I prefer to check the log of the plan before to launch the apply. I think it's very interesting and important to check the log of the planification before to launch and execute really the infrastructure in Google Cloud because sometimes we can have some error in our code and I think it's very important to check the plan code before to launch the apply. That's why I preferred here to use Cloud Build manual jobs. The principle of the apply is the same. I will execute the plan, then TF plan out file is generated and apply launch and create the infrastructure in Google Cloud from the previous created TF plan out file. The destroy propose the same command but for the destroy part and also the same environment variables. And I think it's good. I have in my readme file some commands. For example, for this use case, I have some environment variables that we can set in our shell. I can launch my Terraform code from the local machine and also the current project via gcloud build submit. Also, I can create some cloud build triggers, and these triggers are in my example based on the project hosted in my GitHub repository. I also indicate that I want to create manual triggers. Sometimes we can also create some automatic triggers. For example, if you want to launch a unit test, for example, with Python, many times we want that some triggers and tests will be performed directly and automatically. But in this case, for the Terraform part, I choose to use manual jobs. I set the project ID, the location, also the name of the cloud build job, the link of the repo, of the repository from my GitHub account, the repo type, the main branch, the YAML file that will be used by this command, the substitution variables, and a debug verbosity to have more log. The same command for the apply and the destroy, but that target on the needed and expected file. I will launch this command in my shell. It will instantiate and create the plan trigger in Google Cloud Platform. I will do the same with the apply. Here is only the instantiation of triggers, but the CI elements are not be performed with this command. This command is only to deploy the cloud build triggers in Google Cloud Platform. I have the destroy also at the end. I launch and deploy the cloud build trigger for destroy. I go to Google Cloud Platform in the trigger page. I will refresh my page. And as we can see, we have the Terraform plan trigger, the apply, and also the destroy. I previously managed my GitHub repository here. I connected Cloud Build to my GitHub repository. And I will launch and perform the Terraform plan that is a manual job. I click on Run. We can see all the substitution here. We can edit the value if needed. I run the trigger. When I go to the history, I can see that my job is running. I click on build and I can we can see the log of the current cloud build job. Normally this job will create firstly the custom role for Cloud Composer, then the custom role for Dataflow with the needed privileges. Then I have the service account and the assignation between custom roles and roles with the service accounts. I have my list here. We can see that all the expected resources will be created, and I think it's okay. I go to triggers. I will launch the apply to I see that my log and my code will create the infrastructure as expected, and it's secure. In this case, I can perform the apply. I launch the apply. I go to the history and access to the log. It will take few minutes to create all the needed infrastructure. I have the planification firstly here, and Terraform is creating my resources. He created the composer custom roles, the Dataflow custom roles, and the creation is complete for custom roles. And I think the creation is done also for the service accounts and the assignation between custom roles and service account. We can check the creation of our resource in the IAM page. I go to the service account, I refresh my page, and I have created a custom role for Cloud Composer here. I also created a custom role for Dataflow. When I go to the roles menu, we created a custom role for Cloud Composer that contains only the needed permissions. I have the same principle for Dataflow. And when I go to the IAM page, normally we will see the assignation of roles and custom roles to our previously created service account. I have the service account for Composer. We set two predefined roles to this service account and also the SA Composer custom role. For SA Dataflow here, I set the SA Dataflow custom roles to this service account. The job is good, the infrastructure are created as expected. I think it's good. The code shown all the responsibility. Terraform for the infra as code with TerraGrunt as a wrapper to don't repeat some code logic and to perform the creation of multiple modules at the same time more easily. Cloud Build for the orchestration, CI/CD orchestration and serverless approach. And everything is good. The GitHub repository is in my TosinC GitHub account. And I think it's very good. This use case is interesting to show less privileged principle, modular Terraform with TerraGrunt and Cloud Build. I hope you liked this video. I'm very happy to share my knowledge in Google Cloud Platform, and I plan to create other resources to the community. Bye bye.